Hey, imagine being able to walk outside your back door and straight into a mini amusement park. That is a reality for one teenager in suburban Atlanta. Ben Talladay, he built his own roller coaster with his own two hands. It took him like 3 weeks, the entire thing. And for the time being, he's enjoying the ride without having to wait in line. Even his mom hopped on. Talladay says he would like to one day build similar projects that hopefully others can enjoy.
That would honestly be my dream job, to build stuff like this for people and then see their reaction when they go down it for the first time. But yeah, I've had so much fun building this thing.
What is that? His mom says she's proud of what her son has created, but she wonders when it's coming down.
I was going to say, that's an awesome backyard and plenty of room for a roller coaster.
She's like, I love it.
It's no longer peaceful for her to just read a book outside.
hey. Keep the change, you filthy animal. No, seriously. That's how one guy got his final paycheck, in 90,000 pennies. So reportedly, this Georgia man and his boss got into a fight. He ended up quitting, and then he never got his last paycheck. That is, until months later, 500 pounds of pennies showed up in his driveway. They were also covered in some sort of grease and chemicals. The Department of Labor says nothing is technically wrong with paying in pennies. However, I've been researching this story, so come to me, let me chit-chat. Apparently, this boss is quoted in saying, I don't know if I paid him in pennies, if I did or didn't, but either way, he got his money. So he's really not answering that question.
Okay.
Apparently, the boss called the former employee a weenie.
Oh, boy.
So I don't know. There's clearly some sort of huge backstory. My parents own a store in Chicago, and people pay, and I'm not kidding, they would come in with a dirty sock or like a bra full of change, and there's nothing wrong with that. Okay. You can pay with whatever you want. Money's money. Yeah. Yeah. And also I read that the employee has spent hours cleaning these pennies every night, probably because he needs to bring them to a bank or a Coinstar or whatever.
And they can't have that greasy chemical stuff on
it.
Oh, man.
Okay. Well, speaking of that sort of thing, no one likes an internet troll, but unfortunately, I know it all too well, they exist. So how do you deal with them? Well, if you're this blogger, yeah, fight back with humor.
It's been a crazy week, absolutely exhausting. Yeah, I think I sent like 1,100 messages today. That was just to one mom. Yeah, a new one. she got a nanny. Not on my watch, not on mine. Selfish much, right? I'm just here to look after the kids on the internet I don't know and make their moms feel like shit. Do I have kids? No, I don't have time. I mother in other ways.
She is my spirit animal, because you guys know I do my videos calling out the trolls as well. That is Taylor Wolf, who is a 33-year-old writer and comedian. She's got a blog where she writes about her life. Now, last November, she gave birth, wrote about it, and then that's when the trolls came a-knocking. I feel like, Netta, as a mom, you know, everybody's got their opinion. The new mom started making those videos mocking, quote, the Karens of the internet.
No.
She says this was the only way she knew how to work through it and find humor in the situation.
So. Yeah, because, I mean, you do your best as a mom, and there's no room for that. And there's no time for that either.
A lot of people say, hey, just ignore the trolls. But I say if it makes you happy to make a video and find humor in it, boom.
I know. I like yours. You call out the things people ask you, and I'm shocked by
I just laugh,
the things they say all the time.